must expand, get more pupils, so that the knowledge will spread.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to Unstrapped, the first TV snowboard show on YouTube, I guess you could say. We will be hopefully putting them on podcasts and other things like that. But anyways, my name is Andrew Brewer. I am a longtime professional snowboarder. I've been snowboarding, or professionally snowboarding, for 13 years or so now, from brands such as Tech 9 and Neff, all the way up to currently now riding for a Japanese brand called Death Label. Super cool little brand. And I am joined by my good friend, Jim Dunnigan. How's it going, buddy?
Good, man. How you doing?
You know, I'm excited. I'm doing well, though. Tell us about yourself, Jim. You're from New Hampshire.
Yeah, man. Grew up in New Hampshire. Moved out to Colorado after high school with a few homies.
Full disclosure.
Shout out Billy J, Joey, Hamill, Andrew. Already giving shout outs, dude.
Yep. Full disclosure, I too am from Colorado. Well, from California. But grew up snowboarding in Colorado. So anyways.
So yeah, from New Hampshire, but moved to Colorado after high school and then made my way out to Tahoe.
Yep. And that's where we met.
That's right, dog.
And I live in Reno now. We are filming from Reno, Nevada, in case anyone is curious. So anyways, we are a snowboard show that we're doing. But eventually, like I said, we're going to try to switch over into podcasts, also post in podcasts, things like that. I will try to do my best as we go to describe videos and whatnot, so it's a little easier for just listeners. But anyways, welcome, guys. Stoked you're here. Stoked you're watching. And we're stoked about snowboarding. So first things first, you know, I thought that this would be a great time to start our first episode because something pretty cool finally happened, dude. What is it?
Well,
check that out, baby. Snow at Boreal. So again, we are in Reno. Boreal is about a 35-minute drive for us. But as you can see, man, look at all the people that are stoked. Kurt Wastell, Kevin Jones, Tropic Thunder, a.k.a. Michael McDaniel.
Legends.
Cooper Hoffmeister, Tucker Norad, Professor Pants. I mean, all these dudes. Can't wait for Boreal. Neither can I. I believe my name is somewhere on that list also.
Is Kurt Wastell riding at Boreal these days?
I saw Kurt Wastell in the 7-Eleven parking lot in Truckee and met him.
No way.
So I don't know if he lives here or not, or where he lives. I just thought he was like a Wyoming guy. Is he a Wyoming guy?
Yeah, I don't.
Bluebird, definitely a Bluebird wax guy.
Right.
So I would assume Wyoming. But anyways, that's pretty incredible. We already have snow. Typically late October, ski resorts maybe will start opening. I'm sure Colorado is a little different. They'll probably be opening soon. I haven't lived in Colorado in 15 years, so I don't know. But
you know, Loveland's already open.
I wouldn't be surprised if they're open soon. One thing is for sure, Chad Otterstrom will certainly be posting him self-riding pow lines any day now.
That's right.
Which is classic Chaddo. That dude's a legend. Shouts to Chad Otterstrom. Speaking of Chad Otterstrom, actually, we're going to start on the show talking a little bit about different brands, different stuff, you know, kind of giving you viewers a rundown of new, like, this year or next year's upcoming products, stuff like that. And we decided to start with Academy Snowboards. So Academy has been around for a while. I know their boards now are made at Never Summer Snowboards out of Colorado. But, yeah, man, I think they're based in Auburn. While they say established 2002, Tahoe, California, on their webpage. I believe the graduate board that you're seeing right now, that is Chaddo's board. And I believe he's a part owner. So we got their park board, which is the propaganda. So I've always kind of liked Academy's propaganda board because they're who I don't know who the artist is, but he always does cool. I think it's cool art. Like, do you remember the one that he came out a few years ago? That's like the McDonald's one. Then they did the In-N-Out one. Do you remember all those?
Yeah, hell yeah.
Yeah, so the propaganda,
I love it, dude.
Just your basic park board, super simple.
Selling sugar to kids.
Hey, man, that's all tricks is for kids, right? I think that graphic's pretty cool. Then obviously you've got the Propacamba, which is, I believe, a... Is the Propacamba a regular... is the Propacamba a regular camber? Pop on any pages. Oh, it's a Goodwood top pick. That's pretty cool. Wait, wasn't Goodwood a Trans World thing? Oh, Men's Park 2019. So that's a few years old, but still counts. Our micro camber. I don't know if that's regular camber or what, but if I had to assume, I would think that the Propacamba means it has camber, and that is a regular camber board. Then we got the hybrid 2.0. What's over there? What's that one all about? White or black and green. Maybe it comes in different colors. Built to last, medium stiffness flex. I'm assuming it's a directional board, hybrid, some sort of hybrid.
Yeah, it looks like you're all mountain.
Like wave, camber, and something else. Rocker, nose and tail rocker camber will keep you afloat in the slush, whatever that means. We already looked at the graduate. I know that that is Chad O's board. And then there's the master, which is none other than, I believe, Chris Roach's board. Yep. By Tahoe snowboard legend Chris Roach. He's an absolute legend. All mountain freestyle butter machine. So, you know, the one thing I will say that I do like about Academy, unlike a lot of other brands, is they have a spectrum of snowboards that is simple. There's nothing crazy. There's not a ton. They have 5 models of snowboards. I think that's pretty sick. What do you think?
Yeah, that's cool. I mean, only 5, huh?
I mean, realistically, how many boards does a brand need?
That's true. That's true.
If I had 2 corrections to add or 2 suggestions to add, I would add like a crazier, like fat wide PAL board, or just maybe like a crazy actual PAL board. And then I would also add, I didn't see, I don't know about you, but I didn't see a single snowboard on there for women. I don't know if there's, I don't know if those boards come in women's sizes or in smaller sizes for women. I have no idea, but they do have a video that we pulled up called, I know that they do a team get together every single year called The Gathering, where they all meet up, link up, and go snowboarding together. So let's watch this for a sec. So this is filmed at Sugar Bowl Resort. They're getting off things. There's Chad O. Booty. Where's Booty? Holler. Snowing. Zach Rawls. Oh. I don't know if Zach Rawls is on the team, but
so sick.
He is sick for sure. We got somebody, Baker. There's Roach. Avi. Ripping some pal. So I guess that could be a pal board. I mean, that Master Series board.
Oh, yeah.
Ethan, I don't know who Ethan is. Ethan. Chad O, the ledge. Shouts to Chad O, dude. Oh, Eric Royce, my dog. Dude rips. I don't know who Nick is.
Wow.
We have no last names for the
yeah, we're the last
for,
names
for
at,
the
guys.
Listeners, there are no last names, so I'm not exactly sure who we're watching.
I'm pretty sure it wasn't Nick Russell.
We got some Boreal Park riding going down. I believe this is Eric Royce, or it could be, I think his name's Darren. I'm not totally sure. Not Eric Royce. Either way, this kid's ripping the Boreal Terrain Park. We got a switch front board pretzel on the down rail, front 3 over the big jump, little board slide pretzel, board slide switch up.
Ooh.
Anyway, so this kid's stacking clips for the Boreal edit of The Gathering. Booty is dope, no doubt. And now that Interior Plane Project is no longer around, Booty is on Academy, evidently. Chad O, laid out backy. Man.
That was such a classic Chad O flip.
Dude, the other thing that's so sick about Chad is homie snowboards all summer long, too. He's riding Woodward Copper all summer.
He's the Tom Brady.
Very, Very Tom Brady-ish. You are, yeah, that is a good, a nice parallel for sure. We got this guy rocking the all tan. Couple switch up on some kink rails. Somebody named Baker. I don't know any of these people's last names because,
the editor got lazy.
I mean, I know a few of the dudes personally, so I know who they are, but some of these other guys, I'm not totally sure. Baker.
This looks
Royce. There's Eric.
This makes Boreal look pretty tight, though.
Yeah, Boreal's looking real nice right here. Shouts to Boreal. That is a...
Hell yeah.
Shouts to Boreal, except that, remember, Jim? That last jump cost me a few months of my summer.
That's right.
Because I broke my ankle. I came up short.
It gotta wax that shit.
Dude, that shit was waxed, okay? Okay, well, that's Academy Snowboards, everybody. Comment, tag. Let us know what you think about their boards. I don't know. What do you do? Again, made it never summer. Probably super good boards. I don't know. I honestly can be totally honest. I have never ridden an Academy snowboard or a never summer board for that matter. So I don't really know. Okay. Well, what do we got next, dude? I think we have some clips from Parker Zumowski. So every once in a while, we're going to try to stay relevant and keep up what's been popping up and kind of happening on Instagram and all the different whatever social medias. But anyways, Park Zoom has been killing it lately. He has been doing the Vans movies, Pro on K2. But anyways, I believe he posted this on his Instagram the other day. And just putting a little respect on it, man. Dude's ripping. We love street clips up in here. Up in this show. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
shouts to street snowboarding. But this dude gets bodied a few times. But
where do you think this spot is?
Canada. No, honestly, I have absolutely no idea.
Yeah, it doesn't look like U.S.
I feel like he could be building that jump a little bit bigger.
Like, look at that.
Oh, that looks not in the United States.
Oh, that was just lazy style.
He's super sick. Yeah, Parker's a mouse, man. Dude rips. Pro for K2, as he should be. I know he had a cover of Snowboarder magazine. Or was it Slush Mag? I'm sorry, Slush magazine. Last year, 2 years ago. So, yeah, dude definitely rips. Yeah, what do you think of Parker?
I like the red hair.
Hey, I got some right here. He is one of the gingers out there. We've got a few. We got
is that
Moore.
Sean White?
No, it is not Sean White. Did we just watch the exact same clip like 30 times? What is this new footage?
Okay. Get a little bonus.
50 back gap lip. To those that are watching, 50 on a curb to back lip. We got a little wall ride. Air wall ride. Pretty sick. Jim, can I ask you a question? Are you a fan of unique spots or are you a fan of unique tricks?
I would say unique spots.
I think that a spot is more important than the trick that's done. I agree. I've always been a guy that kind of liked photography. Like, I like to envision what the photo would look like more than what the actual trick I'm doing would look like.
Mind surfing.
Yeah. So, like that wall ride that he just did a second ago. That's got to be a pretty sick photo. You know, all he did was a wall ride. It's not like that crazy of a trick, but what a rad spot. You know what I mean? Back
yeah, that
lip pretzel.
Back lip pretzel is dirty.
Yeah, that was really dope.
Kids
I can
skills.
Honestly say I don't think I've ever done that trick. That is not on a street rail. Not on a street rail. It's insane. Anyways, yeah, Parker Zumowski, keep it up. You're killing it, man.
Hell yeah.
Super sick.
Kid's dope.
Yeah, he's super dope. Next, so we want to transition to a little part of the show where, and it's getting harder and harder because sponsor me tapes are harder and harder to come by. So if you are watching or if you know somebody that has sponsor me tapes, send it in because we want stuff to critique and stuff to for you guys to comment on. So anyways, long story short, we went onto YouTube and we Googled snowboarding sponsor me tape. And this was about the, what was that, fourth or fifth video down the list. Anyways, it's a few years old. And the kid's name is Liam Stevens. And hey, he put it on the internet, so we're going to critique it. So we got a back five that he doesn't land. Another back five that he doesn't land. A back three that he messes up. A front five that he misses his grab on. A lot of flailing. Another missed grab and flailing. A front five he was going for that he had to come up short and open to three. A half. A 360 off the rail at Keystone. A front blunt same way at off a rail at Keystone. A fuck up off an airbag. Okay. Can we pause it, Jim? Can we just hit pause real fast? So if you have sponsor me tapes out there, send them in. We'd love to see them. I actually have been trying. I had a sponsor me tape from 15 years ago, filmed on like a little digicam, and I have been looking for it. And when I find it, I will post it and we will critique it.
That's right, dude. Okay. Let's get it.
We will critique it.
Kids even do sponsor me tapes anymore?
I don't know. I mean, I feel like Instagram is just such a tool nowadays that everyone just uses. I had to go out with my video camera, have somebody film it, and then bring it onto my computer, download it, and burn it onto a DVD where I copied it 7 times and literally handed it out to different people at, I forget, some snowboard event. It might have even been like a Warren Miller movie, dude. Like, I went to it, and there was like, oh, you know, like Burton Snowboards and Dragon Goggles or whoever it was, and I like went and handed him, here you go, sir, here's my sponsor me DVD. And I got 0 results out of it, but I got to meet all those people, and through meeting those people, that helped me a lot.
It's all about the connections.
It really is, man. I mean, if some kid walked up to me and was like, here's my sponsor me tip, I'd be like, dude, you're already on, because you have more balls than most kids that nowadays do. Anyways, right? But yeah, I just feel like it's all Instagram. Like, if you really want to talk to somebody or you want something, you just DM them, or you like have already bought their bindings and you're writing them. Then next thing you know, you're just like tagging them in posts.
Sucks though, because I think that like making a video part, that's what it's all about, you know? And
is it though? I mean, yeah. Is it anymore? Is it anymore?
For me, for sure. Like, the video part is how you express yourself in snowboarding, with music, with art. Everything is your video part.
Okay. I'm critical on 2 levels. I 1000% agree with you. A lot of times the videos you are in don't really allow you to play the music you really want to play. Like, I couldn't put like gnarly black metal on my video part. It'd be a skip part just because people don't want to listen to the song. However, people are, I mean, there's not really big videos anymore. There's hardly big edits anymore. I feel like 90% of stuff is, hey, here's a clip from me today. Even if it's a street snowboard spot, like, for shit, like, I just saw a post. Well, I saw a post a really long time ago of a photo of a homie doing this crazy ass trick. And I'm like, dude, what the hell? You just posted that on Instagram? Like, why would you post that on Instagram? That could have been like a photo ran in a magazine. And before, that was like total no, there's no fucking way. It's been posted on Instagram. That's it's canceled. It's done. And now I just saw it posted in a magazine and I'm like, wait, what the, like,
yeah. Yeah. So I feel ya.
But the fact that they just posted on Instagram right away, as opposed to like waiting the 4 months until the next season's magazines or whatever. But then again, magazines aren't even really around. So I don't know that full parts. I mean, I wouldn't even say it's full parts anymore. It's like, oh, this is my season of iPhone clips. Like, that's like what it is now. I don't know. It's a different time, and don't get me wrong, if a kid's out there like filming and doing dope shit, like I want to see a video part.
Yeah, dude, I love that shit. Like, hold on to your clips. Hold on to those clips, kids. Don't post them.
I know you want that instant gratification.
Yeah, right?
We all want that dopamine hit. But
it's better if you wait.
I agree. I think so, too. Build a little anticipation. And you know what else? I think
it's premiere season, son.
Well, when premieres... Well, there is actually a premiere coming up in Reno, pretty soon. I'm kind of excited about it, so... We'll have to go check it out. But going back to that sort of anticipation of like all this footage you built up, but there used to be mystery behind people, you know?
That's right.
And you were mysterious about what kind of clips did they get this year. Everyone kind of held their shit close to their chest. Like, we used to turn off like our locations on like Instagram because that way people wouldn't see what city we were in filming. Like, it was cutthroat for a bit, dude. Like, I don't know if anyone's listened to the MacDog Bombhole, but he talks all about, like, crazy. Like, dude, it was cutthroat, man.
Yeah.
Cutthroat times. Anyways, okay, so Liam Stevens, do better on your sponsor me tape. Okay. Somebody who does not need a sponsor me tape, and we're just going to kind of just do one of these. You know, we're not worthy. We're not worthy. But Jed fucking Anderson. I mean, so he put out this the other day. He just like, it was like a little mix up mashup of some like old clips, some new clips. So I don't remember if you guys have seen this,
putting the
but
beat down on this rail.
He pretty much does every single trick on this down bar. Got switch nose press, back nose press, fake. I mean,
I got positive.
Shifty.
What about grabs onto a rail?
The fact that you have enough time to air, like the fact when dudes can ollie high enough to put in a full stale fish into a back lip is pretty impressive. On just a regular down rail, it's even more impressive because there's like no time. But I think gap, like grabbing gap to rail is sick. So yeah. Still fish to back lip pretzel, switch front blunt same way, front 180 over the whole thing, front 2-sev, switch hard way 2-sev, hard way 2-sev to regular. Now we got a cab 2-sev to regular. For those that don't know, I believe Jed is goofy. Two nose slide pretzel, looks about to be the same
again.
Clip. Oh, we're rewinding. Yep, nose slide pretzel. Jed is insane, dude. Insane.
He's got that board control for
yep.
sure.
He's a professional snowboarder for Ride Snowboards. Speaking of which, I don't understand how Solomon let him go in the first place for those few years. Pole jam rail, gap to rail. This is this was a little clip from a teaser called Bug Out, which came out last year. If you haven't watched it, you're blowing it. It's insane. Jed is, dude, so good. I forget how old Jed is. I want to say he's like 30, 32. I don't know. But
it's a good number.
Yeah. Video by Justin Meyer, John Stark, and Jake Durham. Bug Out, December 2021. Again, if you haven't seen it, you are blowing it, and you should watch it because it is out now. Ooh. Jed is insane, man.
Where the hell did he find that rail?
I mean, that's probably in the wherever he's from, Toronto or whatever. No, I don't think he's from Toronto. Or maybe he is. I don't remember.
Yeah, he's somewhere out there.
I know he's Canadian, but anyways, tell us what you think about Jed Anderson. I don't think there could be a lot of bad things to say about him because the dude is insane. You got any good comments over the side? No. None that we know of. Oh, Nico Draws commented, so sick, bravo. That's pretty sick. Oh, Brontuan up top, so good. Hiranaka-san? Now we're talking. So, the homies know. For those that don't know, that clip he just showed was a 2-sev to a front book. Oh. Well, this is another edit that he had super glue.
You got a little mashup.
You're all about the mashups, Jim. I like it.
So let's go back here.
You're rewinding again.
That's too bad we didn't get the full clip. We didn't get the full clip.
We have the full clip on the internet. The full clip is on the internet. So this
that's
is like
never been done, right? Like only a few people have done this trick. Front side 270, or I mean, sorry, cab 270, front board, pretzel out.
People have done it. A few people. If you have watched like Bandwagon or any of those old Canadian videos, I think Will Levine does one. I think it's Will Levine. I could be totally wrong, and please correct me. Yeah, on just a straight down bar, which would be way hard. No, on a street rail.
Okay.
Yeah, and that was like 10 years ago, at least 12 years ago. This clip is still psycho. Like, I'm not taking anything away from that.
It's
but
just the most impossible trick.
It
I
really
think.
Is. I mean, I agree. I don't even know where to begin. So, no doubt. That's
we're not
a cool
worthy.
Feature. We are not worthy. We are not worthy. Kennedy. See, this is another edit. Super glue. Also live on the internet. That is such a... Yeah, that's a sick spot. But anyways. Yeah, Jed, man. That dude is just... He is really good.
Imagine
okay,
tomorrow.
Who's better, Jed or Louis?
Ooh, tough question.
Jed did win. Jed did win a half pipe contest.
JED.
I mean, Jed is incredible. I can't be asked this question because I'll be either question I say will be the wrong answer.
Right.
Both of them are the right answer. So if I were to say one of them, it would be the wrong answer because it's both of them.
I guess we got to put on a game of snow.
Dude, could you imagine a game of snow between Louis and Jed? Slush magazine, Pat Bridges, Stan.
Let's go.
Just a live from Canada to Jed versus Louis at the battleground down bar in Montreal. That would be so sick.
Damn.
Dude. Woo.
Who's getting the maple leaf?
Who's getting the maple leaf? Maybe an international game of snow?
Yeah.
I like this.
President's Cup.
Who are you putting on America? Are you putting on Team America, Jim?
Andrew Brewer.
Okay. Well, that while flattering. Thank you. But who's going on Team America, Jim?
I'm gonna have to go with the local, Niall Romanek.
Okay, so I just got some dirty dirt.
Uh oh.
I heard that Niall was invited to go to Game of Snow and said no, he's done.
No way.
That he didn't want to do it.
Well,
I'm a little disappointed because I think Niall would do really, really well. Niall, God, dude, for America, I gotta go with Benny Milam. We've got a pretty funny video pulled up. Actually, no. Before that, we have something even better. So, in recent news, there has been a little switch up on team riders for team people, and that is. Pat Moore has signed over to Arbor Snowboards. So yesterday, Pat showed this. He posted this. To those that want to or can't read it or are listening, it says, I want to give a big thank you to Peep and Tom and K2 Snowboarding for the support over the last few years. Had some great times with the crew and want to wish them the best moving forward. And I saw this, I'm not going to lie, and I was like, oh my God, cliffhanger. Who is he going to ride for? And the first thing that came to my mind, do you know what it was?
What?
Forum Snowboard since they're back. And Pat was a young blood, dude. Like,
yeah.
Pat
Full
is
circle.
OG Forum. I was like, oh, he's got to be going back to Forum.
Oh, that would have been tight.
Yep, that would have been super sick. But that was not the case. And he went to Arbor. But anyways, in the clip that I just mentioned, he's doing a front 12 double cork. God, Pat is so good, dude. Good at everything. But anyways, and then he posted a clip to the next day that said, I'm Pat Moore and I'm now on Arbor, essentially, right? Okay. Now let's move on to another special thing. So Aaron Bittner, as you guys may or may not know of, is my second favorite snowboarder, fall closely behind legend Mark Frank Montoya. But anyways, we want to do a little section on the show where we do like throwback video parts, throwback stuff. Just to kind of like, a lot of people nowadays, especially new upcoming snowboarders, it seems to me, don't know about the history, you know, and some of the dudes that like their styles, like their favorite snowboarder styles came from, you know what I mean? Like a lot of kids really look up to Tommy Gesme. To me, Tommy Gesme really looks like a lot like Lucas Magoon mixed with Mark Frank Montoya, just like super swaggy and like super crisp and just like pure style. Aaron Bittner was one of those dudes that a lot of people were like, this dude's sick. But so anyways,
that's what we're here for.
This is a clip of Aaron Bittner from Unlimited Truth. Of course, mixtaped by MFM himself.
This shit just... I'm ready to go to Boreal now.
The straight import, so zero snow around, middle of summer. Hey, make sure you put on this super heavy jacket, even though it's 80 degrees outside. Kind of tight. Bittner, so good at jumping. Front three over road gas.
I'm going to have this song
nine.
Repeat all winter.
Right?
When I'm riding.
Back three. One thing I also love about Bittner and MFM, dude, they didn't have to do crazy spins, crazy flips just to be so sick. Right? Look at that. There's no snow at all in that clip. Can we bring back imports? I think importing snow is so sick. Front one on, switch front one out, nollie 5-0, back one. It's like in the winter they were like, hey, we gotta like use all this snow and film. And then in the summer they're like, oh, we can hit all these street rails in the middle of the summer, because we'll go to the, because we'll go to the parking or the parking lot of the ice rink and steal some freaking snow.
Dude, that rail is so gnarly with the closeout.
Dude, he hits it. Watch, right there. Yeah. Oh, my God. You could tell he like reaches for his arm. What if he messes himself up? Who knows? You
on
like Bittner?
Phone.
Did you rock Tech 9? Dude, 900.
No.
You did not run any Tech 9 gear.
I rocked that flip phone.
Dude, that was huge. That was so far.
Oh, front lip on the triple
kick? Lip slide, triple kick.
Damn. Kick got
lip
skills.
Slide, same way.
Original
front two
heavy
set.
Metal.
Over pyramid, front five. Dude, that jump is so big. I've seen a couple people hit it in real life. Very gnarly. Front sev.
Is he still riding?
Front board through the kink. That was dope. I've heard that rail's pretty gnarly. It's super narrow.
Look how steep it is.
Yeah, and steep. But anyways, goddamn, dude. Shouts to Aaron Bittner, dude. Homie is so sick.
What's up Bittner. With Bittner these days?
I think he works at backcountry.com. So you want to hear a funny story? So at one point, I rode for DC Snowboards. And while I was riding for DC, Aaron Bittner was a pro on DC. And his initials were in the middle of my snowboard, and I just always would look down and be like, dang, AB, dude. It's my board. Maybe one day it'll be my board, AB. But it wasn't. It was Aaron Bittner. But dude's a freaking – he's so sick, man. Love you, Bittner. You're the shit.
Yeah. You're the man.
Mad respect. Okay. So we like to sort of finish the show. And again, this is another thing where you guys can submit clips if they're good. But – usually we try to not watch them, but this one is, we had to find a good one. So I'm sure you've all seen it. It circled Instagram. It circled the internet. But this is a super funny slash super gnarly bail. Oh my God, dude. Let's full screen this. Cause this is like, dude, it is fucked up. Okay. So this is at Mammoth. Holy fuck me. Oh my. Okay, so full disclosure, when I first saw this clip, I thought this was fake. I was like, cuz if you pause it right there. Oh, we're on Reddit. It's harder to pause. But he like disappears out of the camera. But dude, he is 25 feet in the air right there.
Kid's
oh my
about
God,
to hit
dude.
The gondola.
Dude. So right? Does he? Yeah, right there. He's out of frame. Like, he's out of the frame. That dude is 25, 30 feet up. And then he just comes out of nowhere and just completely destroys himself. Now, I do not know if this person got messed up.
What the?
I it's like he hit so
hard. What
was
he trying right there?
I think he was out of control. I think he was out of control. I think he was out of control and – or he wanted to hit that, but he didn't realize how fast he was going.
Like, he thought it was a jump? You know what I'm saying? He's like, yeah.
I don't know,
dude. He's got his girlfriend with him. He's like, yeah, film me.
She's like, oh, fuck me. She's not like, oh, fuck you. She's like, oh, fuck me. Like, it's going to hurt her.
I think she said babe.
Oh, maybe she said fuck babe. Yeah, he was probably thinking the exact same thing. Babe. Oh, my God. That makes it even fun. Oh my God, babe, you're so stupid. What were you thinking? Oh my God.
Dude, this... Holy fuck,
babe! Wow. Holy crap. Okay. Well,
trying to impress the ladies.
If you guys have any clips that can match that or are around, please let us know. Or shoot them over. Send us some stuff. Let us know what you guys thought of the episode. This is our very first one that we're Jim is licking the tripod. I don't know what's going on over here, but man, you know, let us know what you guys think of the show. Let us know any comments, critiques, or anything like that. It's been an absolute pleasure hanging out with you, Jim, and I'm stoked, man. Let us know what you guys thought of episode one of Unstrapped, and that's us signing off, man. Thank you so much. Peace out.
Must expand, get more pupils, so that the knowledge will spread.